India. Pokesma participates to succeed Sujuta Masker Health Ministry's program. On 28 August 2020, Pokesma has contributed to succeed the Ministry's of Health program Sujuta Masker by distributing 1,000 medical masks to the public. 1 million mask program is one of the national campaign for the use mask of launched by the President of Indonesia, Joko Widodo. This campaign was carried out as a form of concern for Pokesma to maintain public discipline in wearing masks. The distribution of masks was carried out at 3 points at Oro-Oro Market, Malang Kota Baru Station, and in front of Pokesma campus. The mask was distributed to traders and buyers in the market, users of rail transportation, and the surrounding community, as well as one user in front of Pokesma campus. Pokesma, as one of health vocational education, has a moral responsibility to support and contribute to the government programs to decrease the wider spread of COVID-19, said the director of Pokesma, Eugene Susanto. To date, the positive number of COVID-19 patients in Indonesia, especially in Malang, is still increasing as well as in Tenggalek Agency. The data on 7 October said that in Tenggalek there were 248 people infected with coronavirus. Therefore, Pokesma, as the technical unit under the Ministry of Health, will continue to take massive steps to prevent the spread of COVID-19. The use of masks, keep the distance, and wash hands with soap must also be applied massively to protect us and the environment to the spread of COVID-19. Okay, now we move to the next news. On the celebration of Batik Nasional Day, many believe that through the COVID-19 pandemic contribution to food challenge, Batik artisans still stand true, come hell or high water. Chanting Batik Nusantara Foundation initiated to design 74 meters away, with an edition as well as tied entirely using natural days to celebrate Indonesia's 74 independent days and the 10th anniversary of Batik recognition by UNESCO as an intangible cultural heritage. Involving more than 90 artisans putting in a total 216,000 hours of labor, the Batik Garuda Nusantara is ready for public viewing on Batik Day. This celebration took place in the National Museum and Stream Online, supported by the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and the Ministry of Education and Culture of Indonesia. Heo Mutabara, the Foundation Head of Supervisory Works Team, the painstaking effort was started when the President Joko Widodo attended the Presser and Marking Betty on 1st of August 2019 and named the design as Batik Garuda Nusantara. Dubbed by the President himself, the Garuda Batik Nusantara received its name from the Kurdo or Ganja pattern, the first motif to grace the cloth. Other traditional patterns are also present, like para, truto, sudomuti, and skatjaga. As a cultural heritage of Indonesia, Batik becomes the most important and essential national identity of Indonesia in the world. Mr. President also stated that Batik must be preserved as Indonesia brand and the artisan form that have to keep their faith and effort during the pandemic of COVID-19. This event is the celebration of Batik Nasional Day. The Batik artisans around Indonesia, particularly in the region of Indonesia province, also have a similar event to keep the spirit up and support their work in making Batik as a brand. On the 2nd of October, the government asked all staff and employees to wear Batik during the day break as a remark that we acknowledge Batik as the cultural heritage of Indonesia. That's all for our news. Thank you for watching and goodbye.